Hey everybody, Josh Searson of World Alternative Media here, and we are here in Las Vegas for Freedom Fest, and we are joined by the one and only investment expert and author, Jim Rogers. I've been wanting to talk to you for a while about quite a few things, and one of those would be when it comes to global central banking, the global central banking fiat empire, the fundamentals are largely off the table due to the level of manipulation in the monetary system. So it's hard to pinpoint a date on it, but we know the crash is coming, as it always has come eventually in the near 1,000 years since fiat currency has been utilized, going back to, I believe, 1024 AD in China. And with that said, how close do you think we really are to the crash that we should have seen years ago?
Well, Josh, normally when these things happen, they start slowly and they work their way down. And then the crash is the last thing, and everybody knows it by then. But if you remember 2007, Iceland went bankrupt. Most people say, well, what? Mm-hmm. What is Iceland? Then Ireland, then Bear Stearns, then Lehman Brothers, and then everybody knew. Then it was even on TV. So that's the way it's going to happen again. And I would say that will probably happen 2019, but it'll start before then.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of, with the raise of interest rates, albeit very small, it seems to be exactly what you would see right before a crash. And I mean, the central banking system, it's panicking. Janet Yellen claimed recently that we won't see a crisis in our lifetime, which is an unfortunate thing to hear from someone who is supposed to be in charge of the economy, but
she's supposed to know what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
She has no clue.
No.
It's been clear she's been down there 15 years at least. Mm-hmm. She, if anybody gets the credit for this, she more than Bernanke, she more than Greenspan. It's not going to work.
Yeah.
You know, someday we're all going to laugh. The history books going to be full of how Mrs. Yellen said, we'll never have a problem again.
It's kind of crazy. She went to the hospital a few weeks ago. I'm not going to go into why, but it was a medical condition that usually causes delusion. And I think that even without that, it's still pretty delusional. But now there's a lot of talk about investment, which is wise. But how does Jim Rogers best insure himself in the inevitable event of a massive dollar crash?
Well, at the moment, I own a lot of U.S. dollars, and I own them not because it's a sound currency. I own it because when problems come, people look for a safe haven. Mm-hmm. Now, they think, for historic reasons, the U.S. dollar is a safe haven. It's not. Mm-hmm. America's the largest debtor nation in the history of the world, and the debts are going higher and higher and higher. But everybody thinks it's a safe haven. Mm-hmm. They're not going to rush into the euro. They're not going to rush into most currencies that we could name. So what will happen is the dollar will go higher. And by the way, as the turmoil gets worse, Mrs. Yellen and the others will do their best to stop. They will print again, lower interest, whatever they're going to do, they will try again. It won't work. It won't work except temporarily. But the dollar's going to go higher, and hopefully, when it turns into overpriced or a bubble, which it could, depending on how bad the turmoil is, then I'm going to sell my U.S. dollars at the top, of course, and then I'll put my money into gold, renminbi, I don't know what. I have some ideas. But the dollar will totally collapse, but it's going to go up a lot first.
Yeah, and I know a lot of people are a little bit skeptical about cryptocurrencies. I know yourself, you haven't really gone into it that much, because obviously you're not going to go into something that you don't know the full scale of, and it's a new system. It's very new, going back to 2009. But you have to admit, like, there's a lot of a big example of people losing faith in the fiat system when they're flooding the crypto market, where it goes from an $18 billion market cap in January to $115 billion in June. Do you think there's any, do you think it's reasonable for people to be putting money into cryptocurrencies?
Well, I wish I had. The Bitcoin has gone up, you know, what, 100 times more.
Yeah.
So I wish I had. I wish I hadn't been so foolish. But now there are, I think, 2,000 cryptocurrencies, at least 800. Whichever count you want to use.
Yeah.
So I certainly don't know which of the few hundred is going to come out on top, if any. One will, obviously. All our money is going to be on the computer someday. I don't have any cryptocurrencies at the moment. I wish I'd been smart enough. I do know that our money's all going to be computerized eventually. Whether it's Bitcoin or not, I don't know.
See, that's another issue, because the centrally planned cashless system that we're seeing pop up in India, China, Australia, Sweden, Canada, and to a good scale in the United States as well, that's worrying a lot of people, because I often say, if your money's in the bank, it's not yours, it's the bank's. And if your money's always going through the banks through digital transactions and you never hold it in your hands, does that not mean that the bank basically owns you?
Well, it means the government owns you, because the government is very keen to have no cash. Mm. Governments don't like cash, but if all your money is on your computer, then they know everything you do. They can call you up and say, you're drinking too much coffee.
Yeah.
You had too many cups of coffee yesterday.
Yeah.
They will know everything.
Yeah.
And they like that. They like, and they can control it. And if they want to, they just close your account or block your account very easily, just on your computer. So the government is very keen on it, which of course means that we should all be against it. But unfortunately, we're not going to be able to stop.
Of course. Well, now, in looking at the housing markets throughout the world, we've recently seen the return of mortgage-backed securities and collateralized debt obligations. Coming from BMO in Canada and Wells Fargo, the bubble seems to be getting unsustainable in Vancouver, Canada, Toronto, Canada, Seattle, Washington, and of course in the United Kingdom. Do you think we're staring down a serious bubble burst in the near future?
Well, I certainly wouldn't buy property in Vancouver or Toronto or those places you have mentioned, because it's a bubble.
Yeah,
doesn't mean it's going to pop this year, but anytime soon. But it will pop. They always pop, as you know. There are plenty of places where they're not bubbles yet. Go to those places if you must buy property.
Absolutely. Now, I just wanted to close it off by talking about the insane level of derivatives we've been seeing around the world. It just seems like people have lost their way, that people don't understand that maybe you shouldn't be just investing long-term in the stock market, maybe you should be buying up assets, maybe you should be staying out of this system as much as you can, because we're watching just manipulated markets across the board. What do you think is, what do you think the point of this is? Why are we seeing such manipulated markets? Who does it benefit?
Well, we're seeing a lot of derivatives, which is where you started, because there's so much money. I mean, the governments have printed staggering amounts of money, all central banks, in the last decade or so. But there's all this money, cheap money, free money, almost free money in some cases. So you got to do something with it. And there are plenty of people sitting around saying, well, what are we going to do with all this money? And they find new and exotic things to do. You get out the balance sheets of just the major American banks, for instance, and you read the notes, and you will be stunned at the amount of derivatives that are out there. And someday, we're all going to pay. We're all going to pay a terrible price. So I hope that you're worried, and I hope that I know that you're knowledgeable. If you're knowledgeable, you're going to be worried, and I hope you get prepared.
Absolutely. Well, just closing it off, what is your main advice financially for people in 2017 going into 2018 to stay safe, to potentially make money?
Well, first, nobody should listen to me or anybody else. They should only invest in what they know about. If you don't know about it, don't. If you don't know what Russia is, don't invest in Russia, for instance. I own a lot of U.S. dollars, as I said to you before, for the reasons I said. So that's what I'm doing. Agriculture is probably a good place to ride out what's coming. Agriculture, maybe Russia, certainly U.S. dollars, maybe China. These are places where I would be looking if I were looking to save myself.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for talking with us
today. Thanks, Josh. My pleasure.